Today, I'm going to be doing another collaborative art piece for our entire school. For this one, every student and staff member designed a hot air balloon. And first thing I need to do is figure out how much space it's going to take to display all of the hot air balloons, and then make a sky background so that then I can put all of the balloons on display. We're a small school and we have one class per grade. I printed up on cardstock three different sizes of balloons. We have small, medium, and large. And then every class got two colors for their color scheme. So kindergarten was doing small balloons with yellow and orange. First grade, small balloons with blue and green. Second, small balloons with red and purple. Then we get to the medium balloons for third, fourth, and fifth. And then we get to the largest balloons for our middle school, 6th, 7th, and 8th. Okay, so I've just put it down on the floor and I've done three classes and we have nine classes and they're not all exactly the same size, but this gives me a general idea. And this is taking up about 5 feet by 4 feet. So I'm gonna need three times as much unless I wanna get them really close. And I don't think I do. I think this is as crowded as I want it to get, and I might even like it less crowded than this. So now I have to go look at our lobby and see which walls I'm gonna cover with the sky background. Okay, so last year's took up a lot of the wall. I thought it was just gonna take up that section, and then it was so massive, it also took up that section and this section, and it felt really massive, and I thought, oh, I'm not gonna do that again, but guess what? I might do that again. I'm not sure. It just feels like it might be better not so crowded. I'll definitely do the one main wall, but then how do I add to it unless I come on both sides? Ugh. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, it's later that same night. Charlie came and helped me put up paper. I decided to do all three sections. Now I'm going to add some clouds and sky and rolling hills underneath. And then tomorrow or the next day, I will put up the balloons. We've got the sky and the clouds and the green rolling hills, and that's not the focal point, so it doesn't have to be great. The focal point is going to be everybody's hot air balloons, which will totally draw attention away from the sky and the hills, which are fine but not fantastic. And I will do that another day. So I just did all of the smallest balloons, and you can see the time lapse. I was on campus, I had a meeting. It went a little bit longer than I thought it was gonna go. Very productive, glad we had it, but that meant I didn't have enough time to do all of the balloons. So I just did the smallest. I didn't have my ladder in here, so this upper section, I've saved some small balloons to add to the top, and I will come back tomorrow. We had a 4-day weekend this weekend, so I have plenty of time to get this stuff done. These represent kinder and first and second grade and any of our staff members who aren't attached to a specific grade, so like our PE teacher, our music teacher, things like that. That was about 90 to 100 balloons, I think, and it took me 1.5 glue sticks. But I think I'm gonna have to go in and like tack them down later because some of the edges are curling a little bit, so I'll just tack them down tomorrow when I'm putting up other balloons near them. All right, I'm back today. I'm gonna finish the project, but I don't know that I have enough battery to do a time lapse, so we'll see. Got about 60 more to put up, but I need more glue sticks from my room. I've used a total of 8 glue sticks so far, and I think I'm gonna need about 3 or 4 more for the balloons, and then another probably 2 for the Bible verse.
hot air balloons are all up. And now it's time for the last part, which is the Bible verse.
I'm gone. I finished it. Let me give you a look. So I ended up using 4 more glue sticks. I don't remember what my total was before that, but I'll do the math, I'll check the footage, do the math, and then tell you this is how many glue sticks I used in total. I will say something I would do totally different next time is the shape of the balloon had ridges in it, and I assumed the kids would just ignore them and draw pictures inside of the balloons, but a lot of them decided to use that as kind of a grid for their design, which means a lot of our balloons look alike. And so I think to help students be able to know that, hey, you can do whatever you want inside the balloon, in the future I would use a balloon that had no lines in the middle. I thought I might do a gradient of colors, kind of doing like reds to oranges and kind of do the rainbow spectrum. I ended up not doing that and just kind of doing a mishmash of everything. So I think that because I gave each class 2 colors to do and those 2 colors were repeated, like yellow and orange small, yellow and orange medium, yellow and orange large, I didn't end up with a gradient where I could have mixed like yellow and orange and then yellow and green and then, you know, red and orange, and then I would have ended up with that, but then they all would have been the same size. Like, I'm not sure how I could have done it otherwise. I could have just said use any 2 colors that you want and hope that that all would have kind of evened out. But I do like the way it came out, though there are lots of different ways to do it. I like the way this looks, and it represents our school community. Thanks for watching.